How's it going, guys? My name is Zach with the Movie Castle, and today we're going to be talking about Tales from the Darkside. This is Season 1, Episode 5, and this one's entitled The Odds. This is from October 21st, 1984, and is directed by James Sadwith. It stars Danny Aiello and Tom Noonan, and the teleplay was actually written by the director himself, James Sadwith, based on a story by Carole Lucia Satrina. And this is a really good classic example of a Tales from the Dark Side bottle episode. One set, only a few characters, and it really makes the most out of it. Like, this follows the classic Tales from the Dark Side motto of doing a whole lot with a whole little. And you watch the episode, and unless you're looking for it, you don't really notice that this is a very low-budget affair, because you're really strung in, and you really start to go, ooh, what's going to happen? Previously on this channel, I talked about, for Christmas, Seasons of Belief. Seasons of Belief, another really strong Dark Side bottle episode, and they really pull these things off pretty well, and shows you that if you don't mind getting your hands dirty and writing a really good script and pulling the audience in, you don't really need a big budget, you don't need big special effects, you just need a hook, you know, and the Dark Side really does this pretty well. This story has a great concept. There's this bookie, really experienced, really professional, when this man in a white suit, a mysterious figure, walks in and starts placing really out there bets, yet he always wins his bet, and you don't know why this guy is, you know, able to win these really long shot bets, but after a while he says, "One more bet, all or nothing. I bet that you'll die by 8 a.m. tomorrow morning," which is such a great, like, you know, already stories about betting pull you in. Remember that classic Tales from the Crypt episode about the two gamblers? Like, it already had you. And then it took that extra step and leads to this really great, tense final act there. There's some really cool stuff in here. And overall, I really did like this episode. Yeah, a whole lot for a whole little. A bottle episode, you don't even notice it's a bottle episode, and just a really great premise. A guy who's never wrong bets that you're gonna die. How do you do that? How do you win against this guy? That's really cool. Let's go ahead and dig into the plot a little bit more. I'm not gonna be doing any major spoilers, but I do want to say my piece on some of the plot points and make sure you guys have a basic understanding as to what this episode's about. So let's go ahead and dive in a little bit more. We open up with this bookie. It's this bookie and this guy who works for him. And the guy who works for him has this pocket calculator, and he pushes the different numbers, and they all have a different tone, and he can make music on it. They're doing the math to see, you know, who won how much in all their bets. And the boss, and I love how the bookie always goes, "Oh, boss," you know, really just emphasizes that. Or the understudy. But I really do love this sort of his character. He's really set in his ways, yet he's very professional. And the boss says, "Put that silly calculator away. It's just a novelty, a gimmick, a piece of newfangled technology. I do all my math in my head, and it's never failed me yet." And this is one thing I really like about Tales from the Dark Side. You know, being set in the 80s, you really do get to see the world as technology was changing. And you get so many of these little fun, you know, slices of the past. You know, the idea that a pocket calculator can be considered newfangled technology and something, you don't need that, just do the math in your head. I really do love these little slices of the past, you know. The next episode, episode 6, is going to have a lot more technology in it, so we'll talk about that in a minute. But anyway, they're doing the bets when all of a sudden they feel this cold rush of air, yet they didn't hear anybody come in, but there's this guy standing there in all white suit, a white hat, and he wants to place a bet for this horse race, and they think he's already late, but when they turn on the radio, they find that the game had been mysteriously delayed. So he places the bet on a real long shot horse, and he's putting the bet down in silver coins, so it's just already something weird about him. But they place the bet, and of course he won, and he gets a whole bunch of money in return. I think it was like 40-1, and he says, hey, take the money and put it on another bet. And he places another long shot bet, and the next morning when he comes in, the mysterious figure has, of course, won, but so have a lot of other people. The guy had spread the tip around, which is, of course, making the bookie very, very upset. You're trying to break me. And he says to the man, out of principle, I never, ever refuse a bet. And I won't with you. But what I do control are the odds, hence the title of this episode. And the bookie says to him, for you, you're going to get worse odds than everybody else. And if I find out you've been sharing your tips, everybody's odds go down. So he's taking control of the situation without violating his never turn down a bet rule. So he's controlling the odds, but while he's there, they notice something interesting about him. His little understudy doesn't notice it at first, and he's like, look at this guy. Think back a long, long time ago. And they realize, I think it's this guy named Lacey, he looks just like him. And this guy that he looks just like was someone who had killed themselves after losing a ton of money in a bet. And they say, I know who you are now. You're Lacey's son. You're here for revenge. And you see why this guy is going after him so much. You know, his father is dead, and he blames this guy, and he's going to try to take him down. In the book, he said, look, I didn't do anything. I never forced your father to take a bet. He came in here on his own prerogative, and I didn't make him kill himself. He lost his own money on his own free will. But of course, the mysterious stranger is not going to believe that and really has it out for the guy. And after he wins a bunch more bets, he has a ton of money and he says, hey, one more bet, all or nothing. I'm going to bet that you die by 8 a.m. tomorrow. And that is such a brilliant escalation. You know, we were already hooked. It's already this cool gambling story where you're like seeing how far he'll push it. And you know the bookie himself is running out of money. But what do you do for that, you know? You either win all of your money back, or you're dead. And if you're dead, you know, you lose not just the bet, but also your life. But this guy's never been wrong before. How do you get around this? How do you fight off this guy that seems to know everything? And that will lead to your final act. That will lead to them staying up in the bar all night, watching the boss, seeing if he's about to die, and a really tense final act. Plus, you know, you get to find out more about exactly what this guy's deal is. Because, you know, how does he always know everything? We'll get to find out more about that as well. But overall, such a tense finale. It really does build up to a lot, and I really do like the last little bit of this. Yeah, this is really a classic Tales from the Dark Side bottle episode. It's so enthralling, yet one set, a small number of characters, and you don't even notice, you know? And that is really, really cool. If you're a low-budget filmmaker and you're looking for how do I shoot more with not as much money, definitely check out Darkside, especially these bottle episodes. They really show you how you can do a lot for a little, and that is really, really cool. You know, as someone who wants to make movies myself, I really do find this fascinating. But anyway, to everyone who's watched so far, thank you for watching. To everyone who's liked and subscribed, thank you. You really are helping the channel out. I'll leave a relevant playlist on the bottom. This should be my Tales from the Dark Side playlist. You can find my reviews for the first four episodes there, as well as a few that I had to do early, like those Christmas episodes that I had to do why it was December. So not just the first four, but a few more. Anyway, have a good day. I'll see you guys again very, very soon. Relevant playlist on the bottom. Have a good day now.